Hello students, for drafting, pleading and convincing your today's topic is application for bail. So when you talk about bail is something in which you are setting at liberty and you are freeing a person who was arrested or who was imprisoned due to an act, imprisoned upon an action, and it could be in civil or criminal. And in this case, a person gives a surety that a particular accused person who's been arrested will be appearing on a certain day and a place named. So basically, when you talk about bail is the security for a prisoner's appearance for trial. And in this, the person who is giving the surety is bound to make sure that the person who is being given the bail appears at his trial at a specified time and place. There are three ways of understanding bails. Under three heads, you can understand bail. First is bails in bailable offences. Second is bails in bailable offences. In this case, you get the person who is being accused is getting bail for offences that are bailable. And such kind of bail can be taken any time during the while the person who is accused is in the custody, and if that person is prepared to give bail. But the officer in charge in these cases, if in case the arrested person is arrested without warrant, then in that case, the officer in charge of the police station who has detained the accused can also release that person on executing a bond which is without sureties for his appearance. In this way also, instead of taking the accused to the bail, the police officer can do this also. And if in case the person who is being released on bail doesn't comply with the conditions of the bail bond regarding the time and place of attendance, then the court can refuse the release of him for bail, and the person who has given the surety for appearance of such accused person can be called upon to pay the penalties for the non-appearance of the accused. This is under section 446. Under the category of bailable offences comes under the category of non-bailable offences. And in this offence also, the person can be released on bail. But in this, there are certain restrictions to have bail. So if in case a person who has been arrested is arrested for a non-bailable offence, and there is a belief that such accused person is guilty of committing a crime which is punishable with death or imprisonment, life imprisonment, then in that case such bail can be relaxed. But there is also an exemption in this section. In this particular section, there is also an exemption. If in case the person is under the age of 16 years, or is a woman, or is sick, or is infirm person, then in that case, in identification by witness is no ground for refusing bail. Now, anticipatory bail. When you talk about anticipatory bail, section 438 says that issuance of a direction that in the event of arrest of an application, he shall be released on bail. So, in this case, the person who is being arrested is apprehending his arrest on a certain accusation of In this case, it should be the apprehending arrest of an accusation having committed a non-bailable offense. So it should be for a non-bailable offense. So if you have anticipation that you might get arrested for a offense that is non-bailable, then in that case you can the person who can take the anticipatory bail. The only objective of this is that the person doesn't go through the rigorousness of the jail that he might go after getting arrested. So if he takes the bail beforehand, before being arrested, then he would be instantly released on bail, and he won't go through the rigorousness of the jail that appears after the arrest and between getting the bail. So now the application for anticipatory bail and the contents of it is this, that the person should give specific events and facts, should be disclosed by the applicant who is applying for the anticipatory bail, so that it enables the court to judge that there is a reasonableness of his belief, and it should be clear and specific. It should not be vague. It should not be vague. It should be very clear. Rule of prudence requires that the notice should be given to the other side before passing a final order for anticipatory bail, so that wrong order of anticipatory bail is not obtained by a party placing incorrect or misleading facts or suppressing material facts. Thank you.